अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल आफ्टर सो लॉन्ग। टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द थ्योरी फॉर डायनामिक सिमुलेशन ऑन हाइसेस। लेट मी रिमाइंड यू दैट दिस वीडियो इज ओनली अबाउट द थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट ऑफ द डायनामिक सिमुलेशन एंड नॉट द एक्चुअल सिमुलेशन और ट्यूटोरियल। So if you are interested in tutorial part only, then you can skip this video. I will be uploading another video which is only about the tutorial. So you can check it out from I button and description box or directly from my channel. All right, so let's begin. This is about what the basic things you should know before converting a steady state simulation to a dynamic mode. Okay, so before starting, we should know that what is a steady state and what is dynamic simulation. So a steady state is basically something which is not changing with time. If your flow rate is constant with respect to time, if you are changing time from 0 seconds to 5 seconds and your flow rate is not changing during this interval, that what's the matter? Your flow rate is at steady state. Your system is at steady state. Alright, nothing changes with respect to time. Your system is at steady state. But if something changes with respect to time, then your system is at dynamic state. For example, if I have a mass flow rate of 10 kg per hour at 0 seconds and the flow rate changes to 20 kg per hour at 1 second or 2 seconds, then your system is at dynamic mode because it changes its flow rate with respect to time. So what should we know if you are simulating something at steady state, and what should we know if we are simulating something at dynamic state? First of all, steady state simulation does not require any extra information about the system. All right, we should not know that what is the proper system designs or sizing or anything else. We just need to solve the basic algebraic or thermodynamic equations in order to solve a steady state simulation. But if we are, what we normally do is we simulate something at steady state on hyses and then we converted it into a dynamic system. So if we are converting a steady state system to a dynamic system, then we should know the sizing of volume equipment items. What does it mean? That we should know the volume holdups in the system. Why volume is important? If you remind ideal gas equation, what is ideal gas equation? Ideal gas equation is basically PV is equal to nRT. All right, if we know the volume, number of moles and temperature of the system, we can calculate the pressure of the system. All right, and why pressure is important? This is point two of this dynamic simulation, that is piping, pumps, compressors, valve. So the program can calculate pressure difference in this flow rate. This second point shows that why pressure or pressure difference is important if we are doing a dynamic simulation. If you remember, we have simulated pump in hyses on the previous video. What did we do? We just put an arrow from one equipment to another and the system understand that okay, the inlet is this and the outlet is that. But in dynamic simulation, pressure difference is the key. Pressure difference decides that from where to where the flow, the liquid or the gas flows. All right, so pressure difference is the main driving force. We know that fluid also moves due to gravity, not fluid but liquid, as in gases, the gravitational force is almost negligible, so we only consider the pressure difference as the driving force. But in liquids, it also flows due to gravitational force and not only about the pressure difference. So in hyses, we don't have the build-up gravitational force inserted in it, but we can calculate it or we can add it up according to our systems. Then we should know the type of dynamic systems before we switch to dynamic simulation. So there are basically two types of dynamic systems. First one is flow driven. What is flow driven system? It means that it is basically in between steady state and dynamic simulation. All right, we are considering the flow only, not the pressure difference and not the flow due to pressure difference. So it is in between steady state and dynamic simulation. The second type is of pressure driven. What is pressure driven simulation or dynamic simulation? It simply shows that the flow is due to the pressure difference between two equipments. All right, and if we have to put a pressurized fluid from one place to another, what we need pumps and compressors, or if we want to decrease the pressure, we have to add valves and we have to size them accordingly. All right, so basically we need pressure or pressure drops or pressure differences between two points or two systems in order to get a pressure driven dynamic simulation system. All right, we add pressure pumps and compressors to add the pressure, and okay, somewhere we don't need compressors or valves or pumps. Why? Because if you are considering a reservoir, all right, oil or like a reservoir of oil or gas, what does it mean? At reservoirs, sometimes pressures are already so high that you don't need a compressor or a pump to increase their pressure. All right, so sometimes we don't need compressors, but on the other hand, we need pumps or compressors to add the pressure accordingly. All right, to increase the pressure of the system so that the fluid can flow from one unit or equipment to another. All right, and on the other hand, we also have to position and size all the valves correctly in order to get the exact result. All right, as we all know that this is not the exact accurate results which we get from simulation. All right, so in order to be more closer to the actual system, we need to specify all the things correctly so that our simulation is more accurate or more close to the real systems. Now, piping systems. All right, so in most of the dynamic simulation, we do not include all the piping details. Why? Because in pipes, the liquid holdups or the volume holdups are very small as compared to the other equipments. If we are considering as distillation column, for example, the volume holdup or the fluid holdup in that distillation column is so high as compared to the pipes, so we don't consider them. But what if the pipe is extremely large? When the pipe is extremely large, what happens? As I said before, that the liquid holdup, fluid holdup, or volume holdup is very small in pipes. But if the pipe is large, there is a significant holdup in it, and the volume in the pipe is not negligible then. So we have to consider the sizing of the pipe and pipe details also in order to calculate the results. Okay, then it is important to correctly connect unit operations and size valves, compressors, and pumps so that flow rate can be varied and manipulated in order to achieve the desired control strategy. What does this paragraph or line means? As I mentioned before, that flow is due to pressure difference mainly. All right, both in liquids and in gases in dynamic system. So in order to manipulate the flow rate, what we have to do? We have to manipulate or control pressures. And in order to control pressure, what we have to do? We have to size and design compressors, pumps, and valves accordingly. If I want a pressure of 10 bar at the outlet, I have to consider all the pressure drop across all the units in the system and add pump accordingly. All right, if I want a pressure of 10 bar at outlet, I will not add a pump that gives me 9 bar at its outlet. All right, I have to put a pump that gives me a pressure drop of 10 bar at outlet plus the pressure drops all over the system. All right, so I have to design or size valves, compressors, and pumps according to my system. Now, what if we are sizing a pipe in a liquid system. Okay, so this is one of the configurations that we can have in pipes and liquid service. And what is it? Pump is before all the units, all right? This is the pump, all right? This is before the units and the valves, all right? What does it mean? That pump has to be, is it correct or not? It is correct, all right? Why? Because pump is giving you a pressure, all right? Which is included or which has to be dropped here. So pump has to be included before all the pressure drops, all right? And what does this system means? And we add the valve to control flow rate, all right? But if the stream is distributed or is the stream splits in two different systems, then what we do, we put a pump in before the system and then add two valves in order to control both the flow rates, all right? This valve will control the flow rate of this system, and this valve controls the flow rate of these two units, all right? Now we will see some of the wrong configurations that can be added, all right? If valve is added before pump, what is the main problem that we have to face? If valve is before pump, then there is a chance of cavitation. All right, why there is a chance of cavitation? Because valve causes a pressure drop, all right? And less pressure before the pump or less pressure at the suction of the pump will cause what? Will cause cavitation, all right? Which is a major problem in pumping systems, all right? So we do not add valve before a pump, okay? Pump has to be placed before all the pressure drops in the systems. Okay. In one streamline, like here, in one streamline, there should only be one control valve. All right. This valve can be a butterfly valve, a globe valve, a non-return valve, any valve, but not a control valve. Okay. All right. So in this streamline, we can control the flow rate from this valve only. Okay, this valve is not required. This control valve is not required. All right, so we have to emit this. Then if this stream splits in two, we can add these two valves like here. All right, this valve will control the flow rate in this line, this streamline, and this valve will control the flow rate in this streamline. But this control valve is extra. Why? Because the flow rate here will only be the sum of these two valves. All right, flow rate from these two valves add up to this, the flow rate from this valve. So this valve do nothing for us. All right, so this control valve is not necessary here. All right, so we can emit it also. Before doing anything, we have to make sure that our configurations are correct. What we are given to HYSYS is correct. Then we can expect that the results that HYSYS give us are reliable and correct. Then pipes and gases service. Okay. This is the first one. Valve before compressor. All right. This will control the flow through the compressor. But obviously, its flow control will be limited by compressor's inlet and outlet pressures, all right? We first have to see that what are the compressor's inlet and outlet pressure, and then we can control the flow rate here. Then the second one is bypass or kickback. What we are doing here is that we are this is simple stream, this compressor, cooler. Okay, we add cooler after compressor to decrease the pressure, to decrease the temperature of the gas, as we all know that compression is a by compression temperature increases. So to decrease the temperature of the gases, we add cooler after compressor. All right, so what we are doing here is we kick back, or we are like including a stream from product side to inlet. All right, from outlet to inlet side, and add a valve in between to control the flow rate through compressors. All right, then the third one is to increase the speed of the compressor, to change the compressor's speed. And if we want to be free to change its speed, we combine it with a turbine. All right, and this is the most common configuration to save energy. All right, so we add turbine on the same shaft, mechanical shaft of the compressor, so that the energy is saved. All right, so these are the most common configurations in gas systems. All right, the first one is placing a valve before a compressor to control the flow rate. The second one is to add a stream from outlet to the inlet of the compressor, so that, like, if we all know that compressor only works in a limited flow rate. All right, it does not work below a flow rate and above a certain flow rate. All right, there is a range in between where the efficiency of the compressor is high, so we want that flow rate. For that, we put a stream from outlet to the inlet of the compressor and add a valve to control that flow rate. All right, and to save energy, obviously we add a turbine, so we can control the speed of the compressor. All right, so this is the basic things that we should know before going to the actual tutorial simulation of dynamic systems on HYSYS. So that is it for today. Please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you like this video.